No, folks, you're not imagining it. You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper.
And I'm Carolyn Nelson.
Craig Smith called me today and said that he had some personal business to take care of this evening. And so the Hour of the Time is coming to you in the place of Craig Smith and his show Trends. He will be back at the same time on the same station on Monday, just like always. We're going to tickle your fancy tonight. Going to stop you all in your tracks and make you think, I hope. So don't go away, folks. We've got a lot of things to tell you.
With liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The Pledge of Allegiance to the flag and the pledge to the ideals of our forefathers, the men who fought and died in the building of this great nation. It's a pledge to fulfill our duties and obligations as citizens of the United States, to uphold the principles of our Constitution. And last but not least, it's a pledge to maintain the four great freedoms cherished by all Americans. Freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom from want, and freedom from fear. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
founding fathers did something that had never been done before upon the face of this entire earth. They pointed to the heavens and they said, there is a God. And God has endowed man with unalienable rights. They did not say inalienable rights, and you all should take that out of your vocabulary right now. For documentation as to the proper terminology, read the Declaration of Independence, and you will see that they are unalienable rights, which means that they cannot be taken away by anyone, not even by you yourself, since they were creator endowed. They built this nation upon that founding principle, for without it, man is no better than the beasts of the field and is subject to whomever or whatever is the strongest, or the smartest, or the cruelest, or the most benevolent. You throws the dice and you takes your chances. They founded a nation under law, the natural law, based upon that one fact that there is a creator who has set in motion the entire universe, the solar system, and put in place the laws which govern that which he created. One of the tenets of our founding fathers was that this nation was based upon the common law, that is, the law that all peoples throughout history have determined over the millennium to be just, accepted by all men everywhere as being just. The common law stated that the only one who can protect the Creator-endowed rights endowed upon an individual is that individual, him or herself. No one else can do it under the law. The common law is the basis of the law upon which the Constitution of the United States of America and the Bill of Rights were written. At this present moment, ladies and gentlemen, we have lost most of our Creator-endowed rights, supposedly protected by the Constitution. We have no constitutional rights. We have never had any constitutional rights. We have always had Creator-endowed rights protected by the Constitution and the Bill of Rights, limiting government and prohibiting government from infringing upon or taking away our Creator-endowed rights. Over the years, we have become apathetic, complacent, ignorant, and yes, folks, even stupid. I have heard people say that it's not our fault, and I'm here to tell you that that, ladies and gentlemen, is a lie. It is our fault, for we have given everything that hundreds of thousands of men and women have died for throughout the history of the United States of America to preserve. No one has taken it from us. We have freely given it away by our ignorance, through our apathy, and of course, as a result of the great mass of stupidity that reigns across this country. Does it make you mad? If it does, then you are indeed a sheeple. If you understand what I'm talking about and want to do something about it, listen. And don't forget to tune in later at midnight Eastern, 11 Central, 10 Mountain, and 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for the Hour of the Time, for that is the time that we are regularly broadcast Monday through Friday night. Every Monday through Friday night. We can no longer afford to be so wide-eyed and childlike, so stupid, so apathetic, and so ignorant. Americans must grow up, must become real adults, must stop believing what they are told and what they read, begin their own program of independent research, and start knowing. There's a great difference between believing what you are told and knowing what the truth is. The United States of America was founded on a moral tax revolt in the late 1700s. In the late 1700s. There's a tax revolt occurring now in the late 1900s. Both tax revolts share a common catalyst, that is, tyranny of government. Of the 37 particular grievances listed in the Declaration of Independence, 32 of them, ladies and gentlemen, or 86%, are again serious issues for complaint today. Now, if you don't believe that, you should read your copy of the Declaration of Independence. You see, every true American should have a copy of the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and the Declaration of Independence in their home. For those documents constitute the founding principles and ideals upon which this country began its life. And the Constitution and Bill of Rights are the supreme law of this land. And if you do not have a copy of those documents and do not know what they say and understand what is contained in those documents, then you are by no means an American and have no right to call yourself an American. Of the 37 particular grievances listed in the Declaration of Independence, 32 of them, are 86%, are again serious issues for complaint today. The American Revolution 200 years ago was a bloody one. Today's revolt needn't be, for we've inherited the Constitution. We don't have to reinvent the constitutional wheel. We only need to get it rolling again and apply it. It is being ignored by those whom it was written to limit. They do not even pay attention to its limitations now. If Americans don't wake up, if the great herds of sheeple in this nation do not wake up, I can assure you that blood will again flow in this nation. Now, if you will learn to vigorously invoke your God-given constitutional liberties, described by Alan Bloom in The Closing of the American Mind as, quote, hard won over centuries by the alliance of philosophic genius and political heroism consecrated by the blood of martyrs, unquote. Our second battle for American freedom will be won, and can be won bloodless and within the law. It is too late for appeasement. It is too late for appeasement. It is too late for half-truths. Despots and other moral vandals may call other lands home, but they do not belong in America. We deserve to know the unvarnished truth about our money and taxes. But if you're not willing to exert the effort, you see, it takes work to find the truth, and the truth is elusive at best. If you are not willing to expend that energy to find it, then you will surely get what you deserve. The limousine liberals have lied to us long enough. The Potomac parasites have cheated us long enough. The caviar Congress has lived high on the hog long enough. The Washington wastrels have blown our billions long enough. We should not fear our servant, the government. The federal government should fear and respect its master, we, the American people. After all, that is what the Constitution says. That is what America stands for. However, we are taking orders from our federal yard boy. Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 7 says, I have seen servants upon horses and princes walking as servants upon the earth. The Internal Revenue Service and taxes are like bad weather. Everybody loves to complain, but nobody does anything about them except a small handful of people scattered about this country who really understand the law and apply it. The rest of us, we know already how to complain, but today, folks, it is time for some action. A few days ago, as they do every year at this time of year, Philip Marsh, which used to run the Pilot Connection, which is now called the Liberty Foundation, was raided by the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. They were raided by the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. Every piece, every stick of furniture, every piece of paper, every person was arrested and carted off to jail. They had been teaching Americans the true law and the truth about the Internal Revenue Service, the criminal Internal Revenue Service, and the Federal Reserve, which is not an agency of the United States government. And they had been legally untaxing American citizens through the real, the true law. Every year they do this. And all you see in the newspapers is that these people have been arrested. And they imply that they have been charged with violation of the tax law, or evading taxes, or for not filing tax returns, or for not paying their taxes. And they are all lies. They are always arrested on misdemeanors, little charges, and they are usually out within a few days, and then they don't bother them again for another year. You see, the whole purpose of these raids, ladies and gentlemen, is to cower the rest of you sheeple into falling in line, filling out your tax returns and paying them, even though, if you fulfill the proper requirements under the law, you do not have to. The income tax system is voluntary. At 9 a.m. this morning, Friday, December the 10th, federal marshals raided the Save a Patron organization, the Save a Patriot organization on Carroll Street in Westminster, Maryland. Everyone was arrested and carted off to jail. Every stick of furniture, every piece of paper was confiscated. And, of course, no one will ever see any of those items ever again. This happens on a yearly basis. Operating under the color of law, why would the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms raid a foundation engaged in exercising their First Amendment rights under the Constitution to educate Americans on the real law? You see, there's nothing illegal about what any of these people were doing. Now, I want you to pay close attention, folks. These are the natural laws of government. Nothing, number one, nothing in our material world, regardless of the form of government, can come from nowhere or go nowhere, nor can it be free. Everything in our economic life was produced by taking risks and has a source, a destination, and a cost that must be paid by someone, somewhere. A nation or world of people who will not use their intelligence are no better than animals who do not have intelligence. Such people are beasts of burden and stakes on the table by choice and consent. A man or a woman without principles, for which they are ready and willing to die for at any given moment that they are called upon to do so, are already dead and are of no use or consequence to anyone, not even themselves. Government is never a source of goods. It is only a source of costs to society. Everything produced is produced by the people. And everything the government gives to one group of people, it must first take or plunder from another group of people. Because of government's inherent inefficiency and waste, the amount given by government will always be less than the amount taken. And all of you sheeple out there waiting for your free health care plan are in for a big surprise. Big, big surprise. Nothing is free. And all of you who think we must have taxes and we must have government in order to pave our highways are even bigger fools. For if you would pool your money and pave your own highways, it wouldn't cost you five times as much by the time you paid it in as taxes and it went to the centralized federal government and came back to you. Don't you understand how that works? The only revenue that government has to spend is that revenue taxed or borrowed out of people's earnings. When government decides to spend more than it has received from these sources, that extra unearned revenue is created out of thin air through the banks and printing presses, and when spent, takes on value only by reducing the value of all currency, savings, and insurance. And this is called inflation. Wages, not profits, are the principal cost of everything, so real wages, or wages adjusted for inflation, cannot be increased unless there are increases in production and productivity. Productivity is based on human energy, both physical and mental, and tools. Tools are created and replaced by capital formation, which can come only from savings. And there isn't much of that in this country, is there? Savings, and thus capital formation, can come only from profits or surplus. Try to invest losses or deficits if you don't believe me. The greater the profits, the greater the possible savings and investment. What a government taxes, such as work, savings, and investment, it gets less of. What a government subsidizes, such as unemployment, debt, consumption, it gets more of. Debt is always repaid, if not by the borrower, than by the lender. Many lenders are about to discover this as their loans come due. History, ladies and gentlemen, teaches that the most productive and the richest societies in the world, with the most security, have always had the most personal freedom. In effect, the smallest government as well as the strongest property rights. There are no human rights without property rights. Democracy is a code word for socialism. Stop saying that this country is a democracy, for every time you do it, you ingrain the inroads that socialism has made into this country, and you solidify the destruction of the republic. The republic, the republic, the republic. Government power always lusts for more power and continually usurps it from the people. Government power corrupts, and absolute government power corrupts absolutely. The size of government and the amount of corruption are always directly proportional. Government power is always abused by seizing and perverting the law, operating under the color of law. The real law ceases to exist. And with few exceptions, government always determines what is law. Government power is overcome or held in check only by the application of a stronger power. Government power is never, ever, in your wildest dreams, surrendered voluntarily. That stronger power must be, and can only be, the people who collectively have the strength. No government can exist on the face of this earth without the will of the people. The people's power comes from God. If you have no God, you have no power. You are subject to the laws of the jungle. Now that these natural laws of government have been explained, let's talk about money before we ever discuss taxes. And this show isn't long enough for us to even get to taxes. Simply because we're not going to get there during this 1 hour, let me assure you that the income tax is unconstitutional. If it is mandated that you must obey and must file and must pay and must sign your signature, all of those things fly in the face of the Constitution. They violate almost every article and every clause and every amendment of the first 10 amendments. If you don't believe that, again, get out your Constitution and your Bill of Rights and read them and apply them to what you are required to do when you file and report and pay income taxes. It is a direct tax. Therefore, the only way it can be legal is if it is voluntary. And the only way it can be voluntary, because the federal government has no authority and no jurisdiction within the several states, which are independent countries, united for their mutual benefit and protection. You see, under the proper law, the federal government has no power within the states. And the only way that it can tax is to tax the states. And then the states have the authority to tax their citizens. Where have you been, Rip Van Winkle, or I should say, Rip Van Sheeple? Why is it that Americans don't understand their own law, their own country? How have you fallen into this deception so easily? Well, I'll tell you, it started, ladies and gentlemen, with Social Security. No one would voluntarily give up their rights or their citizenship without some benefit in return. So they dangled a carrot called Social Security. We will take care of you in your old age. And they did it to a generation of people who had experienced a Great Depression and were extremely, extremely wary and very, very insecure about the future. Many of them had set aside nothing for their old age. So this carrot, looked very good to them. They were not told the conditions of the contracts that they would be entering into with the federal government, which only has authority within the boundaries of that parcel of land known as Washington, D.C., and the territories which come under the jurisdiction of the federal government. They had no idea that they would be giving up their state citizenship and their constitutional rights and would then become a 14th Amendment citizen of the Federal District of Columbia. And those citizens have no constitutional rights. You see, the Constitution itself allowed for the creation of that limited area, which would be governed by the Congress, and the Constitution gives the Congress the right to legislate in all cases whatsoever. In other words, for anyone who is a citizen of the Federal District of Columbia, there are no constitutional rights, and they are subject to the whims of the federal government and the Congress. When you accepted your Social Security number, you became a 14th Amendment citizen of the Federal District of Columbia. You gave up your state citizenship, and you gave up your constitutional rights. And for those people, you must file your income tax returns, and you must pay your income tax. For you are not protected. You are not protected. You don't ever get anything for nothing. Nothing is free. Everything that you enter into is a contract. Most contracts have provisions and requirements. And you either give something, or you lose something, or you gain something in every contract that you ever enter into. That's how it has happened, and that's how it continues to happen. And you will cement your slavery, and you will put another bolt in your shackles, and you will tighten it down around your ankles, even tighter when you accept your free health plan from the federal socialist democracy in Washington, D.C. You see, folks, the beginning of wisdom is to call things by their right name. That's an ancient Chinese proverb. Now, why is it that they want this income tax? You see, before it was put into effect, the federal government existed quite well on the legal taxes provided for in the Constitution. Had no problems with money. The Congress was responsible for the creation of money in this country, and the Constitution specifically stated that no state shall make anything other than gold or silver coin an instrument in payment of debt. I can guarantee you that none of the states are using gold or silver coin as payment of debt. They're using fiat money or counterfeit money, which has no backing, cannot be converted, is in fact an instrument of debt, is in fact an instrument of notification of the bankruptcy of the United States of America, if you want to know the truth. Now, to survive, we must trade with others for things we do not have and cannot make. Even the most reclusive of hermits must trade with others, at least occasionally. Truly, no man is an island. There are only two possible manners of trading, direct and indirect. The direct trade of goods is commonly known as barter. Don't go away, folks. I'll be right back after this short pause.
Of liberty, of thee I sing. land of the pilgrims Christ. From every mountainside let
You're listening to The Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper.
And I'm Carolyn Nelson.
I want everybody to get up close to your radio, because we're going to get serious tonight, folks. Going to get real serious tonight. 9 a.m. 9 a.m. this morning, December the 10th. Federal marshals raided the Save a Patriot Foundation on Carroll Street in Westminster, Maryland. Arrested everyone present, took every stick of furniture, every piece of paper, every piece of equipment, every copy machine, every typewriter, everything. Just 3 days ago, in Colorado, the Liberty Foundation, which used to be the Pilot Connection, founded by Philip Marsh and his wife Marlene, was raided by agents of the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. Everyone was arrested. Every stick of furniture, every piece of cloth, every typewriter, every piece of paper, every record, even the pictures on the walls were taken.
One of the 10 amendments in the Bill of Rights states the right of the people to be secure in their persons, houses, papers, and effects against unreasonable searches and seizures shall not be violated, and no warrants shall issue, but upon probable cause, supported by oath or affirmation, and particularly describing the place to be searched and the persons or things to be searched. I'll let you guess which number amendment this is, and I'll turn the program back to Bill.
The liberty, ladies and gentlemen, of a circus elephant is restrained to a confined area by a chain that binds him. Though this chain is but a thread, compared to his massive bulk, it provides control, because the elephant falsely believes the chain cannot be broken. This false belief is ingrained into the elephant's mind by the trainers at infancy by chaining the elephant to a stake when the chain was strong enough to bind him. Once this hoax is established, it is all that is needed to control the adult elephant to act the way the trainer wants it to act. The elephant is controlled by the trainer's humbug. You are about to be shocked. Though different from a Stephen King novel, this horror story is true. You'll be shocked at what you hear, for it strongly counters with virtually everything you've been led to believe about money, taxes, law, and government. Ladies and gentlemen, we have lost our country. We have lost America. It is gone. I don't mean we're going to lose America or that we're currently in the process of losing America. I mean we have already lost America. She has been abducted like a child. Like a child. And this program is about waking the sheeple so that we can take her back. It is no longer protecting her. It is no longer saving her. It is going to take her back. You work until May 7th each year for the federal government. Not until approximately May 8th do you finally begin to work for yourself and your family. And with the recent tax increases, it's longer than that. You're barely keeping your head above the water. And that's all you and most other Americans are doing, just getting by, just surviving. But life is not mere survival. Life is about living. Living is about travel, quality education for your children, starting that business that you've always dreamed of, sending your folks on the honeymoon they never had, buying that home which you can pass down to your children and they to their grandchildren. Can you afford your dreams? Can you afford to live? Not with this income tax albatross around your neck. Survive, maybe. Live, never. Unless the federal gorging of our hard-earned money is sharply curbed, the middle-class Americans will soon be suffering under a 45% income tax, 20% Social Security contributions tax, 5% national sales tax, 20% inflation or hidden tax, gasoline taxes, local sales taxes, etc., 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 license fees. Did you know that the average federal bureaucrat pulls down over $42,000 a year while the rest of us make only $28,000 on the average? And if that doesn't get you angry, nothing will. Are you not paying through the nose already? How much higher do taxes have to get? Why are you even wearing the income tax albatross? Folks, it's because you believe. You know nothing, you just believe what you're told. You're told you have to file every year, and you're told you have to pay, and you're told that you must join the Social Security system, and you're told this and that and the other thing by your parents and by your preacher and by the Air Force, Army, or Navy recruiter, or by your coach or your school or your counselor. And you believe. You believe. You make a religion out of life. You know nothing. One, you believe that the law requires you to wear this albatross. And number two, you believe it's an American duty to wear it. If the taxpayers of this country ever discover that the Internal Revenue Service operates on 90% bluff, the entire system of fraud and coercion will collapse. And that is a statement made by an IRS official in 1969. Now, let me open your eyes just a little bit. Neither the law nor any American duty requires you to pay federal income tax. You have been fooled into believing that you are required. The Internal Revenue Service is actually a big bluff, and the only power it has over you is through your own fear, guilt, and ignorance. And after a while, you just become stupid. After listening to this program, you may still feel guilty or fearful, and there's not a damn thing that I can do about that. These are personal emotions which each of you will have to individually battle. Fear and guilt are, however, sons of ignorance. Sons of ignorance. How would you like to start enjoying 100% take-home pay without violating any law or duty, without harming America, within as little as 30 days? At the moment, your tax freedom day is May 8th. That's the day you finally start working for yourself and your family. After reading many different books that you can procure, purchase, or even pick up in your own library occasionally, and applying your new knowledge, you can move your tax freedom day to as near January 1st as you desire. All you have to do is stop believing, start knowing, and then use your knowledge. Use your knowledge. Ladies and gentlemen, all of these raids and arrests are play acting. They do this every single year, right at the end of the year, when all of you are beginning to think about your taxes. It is done to scare you into not following through, into not learning the true law, into not going against those who would steal, ladies and gentlemen, half of your income each year. You say, oh no, I'm in the 28% bracket. No, you're not. You're in the funny farm. You add up your 28% bracket, your sales taxes, your gasoline taxes, your fees, your license fees, your registration fees, your mortgage points. All of these, ladies and gentlemen, are taxes. Taxes. And when you get through adding them up, you'll find that you pay 50% of your income every year to taxes. The income tax is a direct tax levied against the people. And if it's mandatory, it's illegal. The only way the income tax can be legal is if it is voluntarily, given. Just filling out an income tax form and signing your name is a violation of the 5th article and amendment to the Constitution. You are then required to testify against yourself. And I could go on and on and on. You see, none of the people arrested at Colorado Springs with the Liberty Foundation were charged with anything having to do with taxes, because they were not doing anything illegal. Nothing illegal at all. The Save a Patriot Foundation was doing nothing illegal. Nothing whatsoever. And none of the charges filed against them had anything to do with income tax evasion or failure to file or failure to pay or anything else. And there is no such thing as failure to pay, ladies and gentlemen. There are no debtors' prisons in the United States of America, in case you don't know that. So, what's going on? Well, Richard E. Byrd, Speaker of the Virginia House of Delegates on March 3, 1910, argued against the passage of the Income Tax 16th Amendment, said this, quote, A hand from Washington will be stretched out and placed upon every man's business. The eye of the federal inspector will be in every man's counting house. The income tax law will of necessity have inquisitorial features. It will provide penalties. It will create a complicated machinery. Under it, businessmen will be hauled into courts distant from their homes. Heavy fines imposed by distant and unfamiliar tribunals will constantly menace the taxpayer. An army of federal inspectors, spies, and detectives will descend upon the state. They will compel men of business to show their books and disclose the secrets of their affairs. They will dictate forms of bookkeeping. They will require statements and affidavits. On the one hand, the inspector can blackmail the taxpayer, and on the other, he can profit by selling his secret to his competitor. The above read prophecy has become frighteningly true. Everything Mr. Byrd forewarned is happening today. In fact, it's even worse. In the name of income tax collection, an Alaska woman was dragged out of her car over broken window glass by IRS agents so that they could seize the car. To enforce income tax collection on the Inglewood Learning Center daycare school, the children were literally held hostage in a barricaded room by Detroit Internal Revenue Service agents and not released to their parents until the parents signed over what they owed the school to the IRS because the school was delinquent in its taxes. Can you imagine that? What would you do if that happened to your children? These kinds of stories, ladies and gentlemen, are not the exception. They are the rule. All across America, teams of heavily armed Internal Revenue Service and Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms agents are swooping into family homes at dawn to seize property, often for assessments less than $100. The IRS is clearly rabid with power and out of control, and is, in fact, a criminal collection bureau for the privately owned Federal Reserve System. You see, not one single dollar of any taxes that any of you sheeple are paying goes to pay for one bridge or one road or one federal employee's salary. If you will look at the back of your canceled checks after you have sent them in payment of your supposed taxes, look at the back and you will see that it says pay to the account of any Federal Reserve Bank in payment of U.S. obligations. Suckers. When are you going to wake up, sheeple? How long is this going to continue? Why are you giving everything up? Why are you flushing everything? The several hundred thousand men and women have died to preserve and pass down to us. Why are you flushing it down the toilet? How dare you? How dare you? How many of you sent your sons and daughters off to fight a war in a desert in the Middle East and haven't got the guts to fight for what's right here? You're hypocrites. You're liars. You see, no one's taking this country away from us. We are giving it up like so many groveling, whimpering dogs. I told you we were going to get right in the middle of it, folks. Myths. What you believe without knowing anything. Income means any money that comes in. You believe that, but it's not true. You make taxable income by merely earning a paycheck. You believe that, but it's not true. Your employer is required by law to withhold federal income taxes. You believe that, but it is not true. In fact, most employers are withholding income taxes against the law. You believe you are required by law to pay federal income tax on private sector wages. You believe it, but it isn't true. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things and you believed it. You never checked. I doubt if more than three people in all of the listening audience to this broadcast have ever even seen the Internal Revenue Code or any of the laws governing the income tax, much less read them. You should hang your heads in shame, for you are feeding the New World Order. You are helping it to come to pass. And in the process of feeding the New World Order, you are destroying this country. You are stripping yourself of your Creator-endowed rights and the protection given to you under the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. Because you're greedy and ignorant and lazy. I don't know how many times I hear across this country, I'm too busy making a living to study this stuff. There's a lot of things I'd like to say to people who say that. I usually don't. I usually let the fires rage within me and I don't say anything. You believe you are required by law to have a Social Security number. And it is not so. You believe you are required by law to join the Social Security program. And it is not true. You believe you are required to pay Social Security contributions. And it is not true. You believe Social Security taxes are held for you in a trust fund. And there is no such thing. You believe you are legally owed your future Social Security benefits, and you are not. You believe Social Security will be there for you when you are old. Go talk to an elderly person and find out the truth. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things and you believed them, but they are lies. You believe your rights come from the government, and that is not true. That is not true. Our founding fathers did something that no one has ever done on this earth before. They said there is a God, and God has endowed upon mankind certain unalienable rights, not inalienable rights. And I'm sick of hearing you twist around our founding fathers' word. Read the Declaration of Independence. The words are unalienable rights, unalienable, unalienable, unalienable rights. Granted to us by a creator. The Constitution was written as a contract between the sovereign people and the sovereign states together for their mutual benefit and protection to protect those creator-endowed rights and to secure them and to guarantee the pursuit of life, liberty, and property, not happiness. Read the words of our founding fathers. Without property rights, there are no rights. You believe the government can require you to waive your rights, and that is a lie. Creator-endowed rights cannot be waived. You cannot give them up. You believe that you can be required by law to be a witness against yourself, and that is a lie. You believe you are required by law to file federal income tax returns, and that is a lie. It is a violation of the Fifth Amendment to the Constitution. You believe you are required to show your books records to an IRS audit, and that is a lie. You can never be required to testify or bring testimony against yourself. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things and you believed it, but they are lies. You believe what's good for the federal government is good for America, and that is a lie. What's good for the individual is good for America. You believe you have a duty to the federal government, and that is a lie. You have a duty to the Constitution and to the Bill of Rights and to nothing else. You believe those who resist the federal government are traitors to America, and so you help the destruction of the rights of the individual, and you help to create the usurpation of the creator-endowed rights of the people, and you help to build a huge democratic socialism which will enslave you. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things, and you believe them, but they are lies. You believe that income taxes are the necessary price we pay for civilization, and that is a lie. You believe if we stopped paying income taxes, it would hurt America, and that also is a lie. How did this country survive without income tax for 170 some odd years? More than that, actually. You believe you have a moral duty to pay your fair share of taxes. If you volunteer and you wish to pay that money, that's up to you, but you do not have a duty to pay anything other than what is legal and constitutional. And a direct tax against the people is not legal, is not constitutional. You believe tax avoidance is a crime like tax evasion, and that is not true. The Supreme Court has ruled that you have a right to avoid taxes legally. You believe that tax avoiders get a free ride and make the rest of us pay more, and that also is a lie. No one has ever paid more because anyone else has refused to pay. You believe if you don't pay your taxes, you deserve to go to jail. And that requires no comment from me. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things and you believed them, but they are lies. You believe the Federal Reserve is part of the federal government, and that is a lie. It is a private corporation. You believe the Federal Reserve notes are dollars, and that is a lie. A dollar is a specific, defined within the law, measurement of gold and silver coin. You believe that inflation is caused by high prices, and that is a lie. Inflation is caused by making counterfeit money available to the people in large amounts, cranking up the printing press and printing out money that has no backing, no support. It is also caused by making available bookkeeping money, in other words, money that doesn't exist in the form of credit. You go to the bank, you borrow $40,000, they make a bookkeeping entry and issue you a check. The money never existed, never will exist, yet you must pay it back with interest, sucker. Sometime, somewhere, somebody told you these things and you believed it, but they are lies. You believe the Constitution is archaic and suitable only for a rural society, and that is not true. It is a living Constitution. And the fact that it is not being changed means that the will of the people is for preserving it as it is. You believe the Supreme Court is to interpret the Constitution, and that also is a lie. You believe all regulations must be obeyed as law, and that also is a lie. Most regulations do not even cover you and are not law. Regulations are not law. You believe a juror can only judge the facts and never the law, and that is a lie. The reason our founding fathers created the jury system was to judge the law as well as the facts. Somebody somewhere sometime told you these things and you believed. You believe America was designed to be a democracy, and I hear that word bandied all over this country. Democracy is a code word for socialism and always ends up in destruction from within. And a dictator rises to power to clean up the mess. Always, in every instance. This is not a democracy. It was never designed to be a democracy. It is a republic, and most of you don't even know what that word means. You believe the legal term United States always means the 50 states, and that is a lie. You believe the federal government has total authority over the 50 states and you, and that is a lie. You believe the purpose for the war on drugs is to eliminate drugs, and that is a lie. The only thing it has eliminated is our creator-endowed rights guaranteed by the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. We have almost lost all of those creator-endowed rights protected by the first 10 amendments. Don't believe it? You must be standing upside down with your head at least 1 foot below the surface if you don't know that. You believe we live in a free country, and you are a fool. Don't go away. Don't you dare go away, because I'm not finished.
The preacher man says it's the end of time, and the Mississippi River sees a gold dry. Is up and the stock market's down, and you're only getting mugged if you go downtown. I live back in the woods, you see, a woman and the kids and the dogs and me. I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive. And a...
Ladies and gentlemen, this program, The Hour of the Time, is brought to you by Swiss America Trading. Throughout the history of the world, there's only been one thing, one commodity that has ever protected anyone against total loss of everything that they've ever built up during severe economic trauma, and that one commodity is precious metals in its various forms. If you would like some protection, and I strongly advise you to get